We're all rebelled up here on the Rebel El Camino. Hey, I got a bunch of stuff in. Actually, first, I put up my 5x8 flag, which is a bunch bigger, and I got a couple extras from Rebel Nation right here. So, we got two extra Z's. Also came in from Leather Up, concealed carry denim vest. What's going to go on the back of here is we got patches from COOTER'S. I got this from COOTER'S. It's a big 9x12 Confederate flag that's going on the back of that denim jacket. I've already sewed on this vest, which is from, it's a concealed carry vest from Leather Up, COOTER'S Garage, Sons Confederate Veterans patch. Also put it on this jacket from Leather Up. I actually had one of my favorite leather jackets from many years ago rotted away after about 15 years. I got one left that it's not a good jacket, but it's nice and lightweight. I use that a lot, but it's also got a COOTER'S patch on it. I'm not showing it there. I actually put this patch on my field jacket too. My, it was an M265, forgot what that is, M65 field jacket. The one that used the woodland green pattern. And I love these patches. You got to dig for these. You got to go on his site, COOTER'S Garage, and look for, this is Hog Go Co. Gasoline. Actually, this would make a great back patch if it was bigger. Or, I might put it over that, just like that. Oh, that'll look, that's freaking cool. That's what I'm going to do with this one. That one's going over that. I also got this COOTER'S Mechanics jacket. I'm going to use this as my riding jacket when it's not too cold out. It's got some pockets up here in the sleeve, which is freaking awesome. It's got pockets over here. These sleeve pockets are great. It's already got the COOTER'S Garage patch already sewn on it. What I'm probably going to do is probably put one of these patches on one of the sleeves. And this one, Hog Go Co. Gasoline over there. And, I might use, Hog Go Co. Gasoline on this right here, on this pocket. Right here. those are so cool, man. I love those things, man. You know, I was saying, right now I'm actually, I'm in for a lifetime membership in the SEV, so I'll be getting a lifetime patch pretty soon. But, one thing, I'm hoping to be getting here pretty soon is, and going on some of the rides. One of the problems I have with the long distance rides is got all these cats. I gotta feed them, you know. So otherwise, I'd have no problem with them. The Sons of Confederate Veterans Mechanized Cavalry. So you know, I'm gonna be dry. I'll be one of these. This jacket here is gonna be reserved, the leather one, for that patch. You know, if or whenever it comes in. But I'm also going to, you know, it also has, you know, this COOTER'S Garage on here, Sons of Confederate Veterans. It's going to have this, too. It's going to have that, too. So, and I'll probably be flying the colors when I'm riding the bike. I also got the plate in the front. So, you know, let the haters hate. You know, we're just out here freaking doing our own thing, man. But check out COOTER'S site. And I got some of these, too. These are cool. I mean, that's just a regular flag, but, you know, the subdued cami one. That's a good one too. You know, that might go on the opposite sleeve of this jacket on my right arm, because I'll probably be using this for mechanic work too, for real. And I know the one side I lay on is not the left side, it's the right side. And I'll probably spray some kind of stuff on here so these patches don't get screwed up. But if this one gets a little dirty, you're not going to notice it. That's another thing too. That's a good patch, too, to have if you're afraid of being in an area to have the flag or something flying or something. Who the hell knows? No guts, no glory, man. You know what I'm saying? So, this phone's a little funky here sometimes, but that flag actually flies pretty damn good. It's all braced up. You can see with the strings down there, paracord and stuff. It ain't going nowhere. So, anyway, new Rebel flags from Rebel Nation. Rebel Nation's got very good deals on 3x5, 4x6, and 5x8 flags. They're heavily discounted. COOTER'S got discounts on their flags. Some of the stuff at COOTER'S you can't get anywhere, like anything that says COOTER'S on it. Like I showed yesterday. Oh, I don't have that knife on me. I was using this one here. The COOTER'S garage, or COOTER'S 01 General Lee combination Swiss Army knife. It's got like all the different can openers on it, the scissors, the Phillips screwdriver, the saw, the regular screwdriver, you know, a whole bunch of garbage, you know. It's a great stainless steel jobber, and I'm going to be using that riding a bike too, so. But, you know, I really wanted to call attention to some of the other patches that, you know, you see the Rebel flag or Confederate flag all the time. You don't really see, you might see that sometimes too. You don't see too many to say COOTER'S Garage. COOTER'S Garage is a really cool patch, I mean, in my opinion. And this one, I just happened to notice the other night or so, but maybe less than a week ago, was this. I said, that is cool. This would make an awesome full back patch, but I think it's going to make an awesome back patch just by that, with the flag and then Hogco gasoline right above it. Because, you know, people, when they see this, you got to make sure you're putting out a psychological message that you're not, you know what I mean? They get, their people are brainwashed with the major media about the flag, right? So, I mean, if you see this Hogco gasoline with the Rebel flag, you might think twice, you know? Hey, what's that? That's a little different. And of course, if you got COOTER'S Garage on the front and Hazard County Garage, of course, I'm going to have, I think on the front of this one, I'm going to wait till, I think I'm out of these patches. I already sewed up a bunch of these already on stuff. I'm going to wait till I get my Sons of Confederate Veterans Lifetime Membership approved. And then the Lifetime patch, I'm going to order a Lifetime patch, and it's going to go on that thing. It's going to go on there. So, getting back into riding again on my bike. Not that I've ever really been totally off the bike, but it's the same bike, motorcycle I've always had. You know, I want it to, actually, part of the reasons I'm riding is for heritage reasons or Confederate reasons. Confederate honor reasons. Let's leave this heritage word out of it. Confederate honor reasons. And, I'm going to be displaying the Confederate flag while I'm riding. It's got the plate in the front. It's got, you know, even my bike cover's got a, well, you'll see it. I think I'll come right around here, man. You'll see it right here. Oh, I got it down here. But, I have a Confederate flag bike cover for this thing. And we got, you know, the plate up here in the front that has, I don't know if it's going to come out of this camera because it's kind of there, right there, see? Right there, Confederate flag. And I'll be wearing it on my back too, so. I got a couple tips I'm going to be displaying about this bike too. A couple things. Because I actually am a kind of a MacGyver guy, and I've been, you know what, most people when they ride from up north, they'd be lucky if they ride 3 months, 2,000 miles, so I got a lot of miles under my belt, actually, total, that's all on that bike, virtually all on that bike, so it's kind of like the same thing when I got back on there again, but I'm going to be, here's the flag, here you go. How's that, huh? And that pole isn't even whipping around now with just reinforcements on it. It picks up the wind real good. It's not even, there's a light breeze out there and it's doing that. So, but I'm gonna have some bike tips too. We'll start getting a lot more of those. I'll probably have to do some more serious, not that serious, but a little more stuff that I haven't done on that bike in a while for maintenance. And we're getting into some other things, but if you want to actually get some patches that are not that politically incorrect, you know, you can go with, you know, Subdued Flag for one, you know, COOTER'S Garage, Hazard County Garage, Hogco Gasoline, which has the flag on there too. You know, a lot of people would double take on that. I'm going to be displaying that big 9-inch by 12-inch on my back on that one. On this jacket, if I get that patch for the Sons of Confederate Veterans Mechanized Cavalry, it's going on this jacket. You know, if I don't get it, I'll get another freaking flag like that and put it on this one. No matter what, whether I'm in that organization or not, I don't think there's a problem with it, because, you know, but whether I'm in the organization or not is I'm still doing this because I like, that's the whole purpose for me getting into this, asking to be in the Sons of Confederate Veterans Mechanized Cavalry, is for Confederate honor purposes, honoring, you know, the gray and the ideals that they fought for. Not what the media tells you they fought for, okay? You know? You know, you could do some of this stuff, and you could do it more subdued than I'm doing it, you know. But, you know, people give me some crap. I mean, the first thing out of my mouth is, well, I'm also a member of the Sons of the American Revolution. You got a problem with that? And, you know, I'm also a member of the Sons of Italy. Sons of Italy. I'm half Italian from my mom's side, right? I'm half Confederate, half Italian, whatever. Nice combination. But, you know, you got a problem with that. So, I mean, come on, man. I don't know why the money don't like this emblem, because it's about limiting their powers and, them using the government as a regulatory agent to stomp out small business competition to them, now as a way to bankroll a lot of their projects through, like, foreign aid, which they give money to a foreign country, and then... That allows that foreign country to buy from all the big businesses over here. They're hooked into it to the freaking government policies. And then if they don't pay the money back, even though the money was loaned from the U.S. government taxpayers, they forgive the debt. Meanwhile, somebody over here made a lot of money off the sales they got to the guy that got lent the money, who actually was given the money. So that was one of the deals that the Confederacy fought over, because what was going on was the railroads were getting subsidized heavily by... the North, in the North through the federal treasury, and the South was putting all the money in it. And if you look after the war, I'm going to actually do a video on it later. I got to do more research about it, the corruption in the railroad industry. But from 1865 to 1873, you could tell who won. The railroads built 33,000 miles of railroad track inside 8 years. And it was like rife with corruption. It was all over the place. It was in the papers that people were taking politicians and people in position of government were taking all kinds of bribes and got a payroll for the railroad, all with taxpayer subsidies, and they're getting subsidizing the railroads, who in turn bribing the same government officials in other areas of the country. It's corruption to the max. And the whole thing was such a boom that it led to a bust, which led to the Great Depression of 1873, or Panic of 1873, when they demonetized silver. There's a lot of stuff out there. You'd be surprised that, you know, the North didn't exactly win the war. It wasn't. You can't say the North won the war. You got to say certain Northern financial interests won the war. Then you start finding out that's what it was about. Certain Northern financial interest. So, yeah, I don't just talk about heritage. I don't even just talk about it. Well, honor is, you're fighting that. See, they're fighting a noble, just cause. And this is a genuine... I got to keep this tag. You know? Crazy Cooter coming at you. Come on back. And, it's Crazy Cooter. You know, I may be crazy, I may be dumb. So, yeah, this guy beeping at my horn. You hear that guy? He's beeping at my thing here. So, I got my CB antenna up here. Crazy Cooter antenna. I'm surprised Cooter don't sell freaking... That was a friendly, good old boy, beeping the horn and stuff, acknowledging the flag. I got out here with my friends here. Let me see this. So it's Confederate veterans. It's all lit up at night with a bulb and all that stuff like that. We got a little yard sign over there. We got the big old flag right here, too. So how's that? Okay. Doing pretty good. So... you got the forest flag out here. It's on a lower pole, smaller pole, 12 star. You got the Army of North Virginia right here. But you know what happens? People are, you know, it's almost like I'm more attracted to this Confederate stuff right now. First off, I know it's righteous. I know they're the underdog. I know they're being, smeared. And there's loads of disparaging comments against them. They're total lies. That's actually attracting me to these guys, the underdog. It's almost like the Harley thing, except the Harley thing, the Confederate thing is like the Harley thing, you know, on steroids. You know, people never liked Harley. Now all of a sudden everybody's, you know, well, they kind of getting out of it again, maybe a little bit. But you know what happened, right? Like, me doing this is probably going to cause more people to do it. Hey, somebody's going to say, I'm going to put a bigger flag up than you got. Maybe I got a 27-foot one. Maybe I'm going to put a 35-foot flag up there with a, you know, a 6x10 flag versus a 5x8. You know, to try to outdo me. It would be competition with the Joneses. Who got the biggest rebel flag? And all of a sudden, you're going to see thousands of them up here. Then the media's going to be saying, scratching her head, well, wait a minute, we're catering to the wrong people. See how that works? Then YouTube's going to figure it out, because the media and the advertisers are really fed by the buyers. Really, who feeds them? The buyers. What are the advertisers trying to do? Meet the buyers. Now, people are into this stuff, and they're not afraid to be into it. Or maybe they get into it because it's like cool or something. You know, hey, it's, we're rebelling. Actually, in a way, a lot of it is somewhat of that nature. Even though the South was only trying to be independent and really didn't want a war, they were invaded. In some ways, you know, this flag is I know it's a Confederate battle flag, and this is the Army of Tennessee, the rectangular one. Of course, I have a couple of official ones up there with the square ones, like the Army of North Virginia battle flag. But, you know, people realize, you know, it's also, you know, even though it's not really correct to call it a rebel flag, in a way it somewhat is today. You know, it's changed a little bit of the meaning. It's kind of like, in some ways, I guess the session was about, like, the heck with all this garbage, we're out of here, we're getting screwed over. And, you know, so they broke away. They tried to break away. But even if you look today in the South for the next umpteen years after the war between the states, you notice the political map, every time there's a presidential election, virtually every time practically, the Northeast votes one way and the South votes another way. Now, my family up in the Northeast are in the two counties in New Jersey where it's... they vote with the South. There's actually two counties in New Jersey that vote with the South. And both in my family votes, for at least the ones I talk to anyway, not the other ones. The ones I talk to vote with the South, you know. But you notice there's always been a division between the North and South, the way they think, no matter what. And that has nothing to do with, you know, has to do with individual rights, man. Freedom, true freedom. That's what this flag's about, true freedom. That's why the money don't like it, man. But, you know, I'm going to tell you this, even the advertisers on YouTube, you know, their money, what they're trying to do is make sales to a wider audience. If they want to miss out their entire, there's a lot of people down South that love this stuff. They want to miss out on the audience, that's their problem. But anyway, I'm actually throwing a lot of free plugs in for Ben Jones, former congressman in the United States from Georgia. He's now located, I think he's up there in Tennessee. He actually lives in a pre-Revolutionary War, built before 1776 log cabin up there in Tennessee. You know, and like I was saying, one of the problems I'm going to have with getting out of here is I got to feed my cats and watch them. So, you know, as much as I'd love to get on some of these long rides and get up to Tennessee, that's going to be somewhat of a logistical problem, but I'll figure it out. Got to find a crazy cat lady who freaking wants to take care of my cats if I'm gone for a while. So, should be a few of those around. But we're getting patched up with these things. You know, I was thinking about getting, you know, the third national flag, you know, the stainless banner and stuff. I says, you know, I want to be a little different. And since I'm so heavy into mechanical stuff, man, I really like COOTER. To tell you the truth, I like Boss Hogg. I would have been his accountant, to tell you the truth, man. Oh, he would have been making 12 times as much money as he was making. We'd be spreading the Confederate message, you know, Jefferson Davis Hogg, Boss Hogg. That guy was a fantastic actor too. I can tell you, man, I crack up laughing every time. I haven't even watched all the episodes yet. I missed some. I ordered some from COOTER'S, and COOTER'S sells all those on DVD. Actually, I ordered, I think, 5 seasons. I think there's 7 seasons total, not 6. And I missed a couple seasons, and I watched them all of maybe 20 years ago or 15 years ago, but then I rewatched them today, and I've been watching them again. I'm not even done. Some of the ones I never saw, and it's cool because I never saw them. But even the ones I saw before, I know I must have watched them. I don't remember them from like 15 years ago. It's like watching them like brand new. That's a damn good show, man. That Cooter's, Dukes of Hazzard, you know? Go support Cooter's. Go support, Leather Up. You know, if you want to, you got a place to put your patches on, Leather Up's got some good jacket deals. And also, this Rebel Nation place has a lot of good stuff. But Cooter's got some individual stuff that's only he has with his emblem. Cooter's Garage, Hazzard County Garage. I got that Hazzard County sign out there. I got Roscoe P. Coltrane from Cooter's. I got the Cooter's Garage sign from Cooter's. I got the Hazzard County Garage from Cooter's. Redneck Parking, I might have got it from Cooter's or C.H. Skidell's. This one I got from Bud K. or C.H. Skidell's out of Georgia. The one, Dixie Motor Oil. I like that sign. It's a very good sign. That would also make a great biker patch, too, to tell you the truth. If you want to put a patch on it, doesn't just have the flag, you could probably, scan that sign or image and send it in and have a custom patch made. And it would still have the Rebel flag on it. Cooter's ought to make a big patch like this, Cooter's Garage. It goes on the back like that. And then you put the hot coat gasoline right above it. I mean, say you're a little afraid to display the freaking Confederate flag too much. See, this would be a cool biker patch. This, I don't know how much it would sell, but I just love this patch, man. I got it on everything. I got it on my t-shirts. See this? I got it on t-shirts here. Yeah, see that? That's on my t-shirt. I got it on all my t-shirts, everything, man. So I bought some more of those suckers, man. They're going on this thing. Well, it's already on that one. It's going on this one. The hot coat gasoline's going on this one in the pocket. This is going to go. I'm going to put this on one sleeve and maybe this on the other sleeve. And hot coat gasoline in the front on the other side of the jacket with this one. I'm going to patch them up a little bit. But there's nothing political here, you know? I mean, maybe that might be because they're brainwashed, man. But that's old Beauregard's design, man. By the way, Beauregard was French and Italian. I always reminded Italians up in the Northeast, Beauregard was half Italian. Italians up north, Northeast, even if they got no Confederate heritage, they do not like people just messing with these statues. Even though it's got nothing to do with their heritage at all. The Italians, the Italian Americans up in the Northeast, they do not like people messing with these statues. So we got allies out there. I'm half Italian, but, kind of identify with both. But I got the heritage from South Carolina from the Confederacy, four direct descendants, and I got four direct descendants from South Carolina in the Americans' Revolution in 1776. And they served under General Francis Marion. You know, the swamp fox, they call them over there in South Carolina. So, anyway, over and out, talked enough, but it kind of went on some various subjects. Well, we'll keep it flying, and we're going to be riding with that flag. And hopefully if I get a crazy cat lady to watch my cats, I go on some longer rides versus day rides or something. But I'll be out there today riding with the flag. I got another vest. There's a huge flag on the back of it already. So I ride with that one over my leather jacket.